Hello everybody, Christopher here. I am just finished my shift for today, and I just thank God. I went on a break walk, a walk at break, and I met these two girls. They were homeless. They asked for food, but I didn't have time to come back home and get it before my break was over. But I got to share the gospel with them and told them that I would pray for them, that God would provide and or give them direction on where to go and to be able to get some food. And then I got home. Well, I prayed for them as I left. And then I got home, and then my lunch break, I decided, hey, maybe they're in that area. So I took a bag of chips and some water with me, and I walked back that same way. And they weren't there, but I found another young man who appeared to be homeless. He was laying on a cement step, covered his head with his jacket, and was napping and in front of a bunch of people. And I walked up to him and grabbed his toe, shook his foot. And then one guy who was standing around said, oh, we talked to him already. He agreed that he'll get up in half an hour and leave. I said, oh, well, I wanted to offer him some food. And he said, well, we tried that, but he didn't seem to want any. So I called out to him. I said, hey, do you want any food? Do you want a bag of chips? And then he took his jacket off his head and accepted it. And then I got to share the gospel with him. I asked him if he's ever heard about Jesus and what he did. And he said, no. It's very rare that I have actually encountered someone who's never heard about Jesus and what he did. He was a young First Nations North American Indian man. And I just spoke to him about the gospel. And then while he ate the chips, and I offered to pray for him, he didn't want anything. He said, I'm good. And then I walked away from him. And as I walked away, some lady named Dawn, I think is her name, she was walking towards me with a walker. And I asked if I could pray for her for healing from Jesus, from God. And she said, what? I said, well, I explained it again. She said, well, sure, if you want to. So I asked her what she was dealing with. She said she has pain in both her knees, needs one knee that was already replaced, fixed, and her other knee replaced. And she said she's dealing with pain and arthritis, oh, and diabetes. And so I asked if I could put my hand on her knee. She said no. I said, well, could I put my hand on your shoulder? I explained, well, the Bible says believers lay hands on the sick and they recover, and I like to obey the Bible. And she said, sure. And then I put my hand on her shoulder. I commanded, I said, diabetes, arthritis, pain, go, leave Dawn now in the name of Jesus. The kingdom of heaven has come upon you. And then I took my hand off, asked her to check it, and she walked a little bit. She said, no, it's still there. So, well, can I pray again? She said, sure. So I put my hand on her shoulder again, and I just said, pain, go. Be healed now, in Jesus' name. And then I just stood there for like a couple seconds, let my hand off, and then I said, how about now? She started walking, and she's like, much better now. So I just said, trust in the Lord Jesus, believe in him, you will be saved. He's our healer, he's our Lord. And she nodded her head, and then she put her mask over her face. I was like, you know, that doesn't help at all, right? And she says, oh, well, it does a little bit. And I said, well, it's the viruses are so tiny. And she's like, well, if you, I know, like if you're like a woman who has bare legs in the winter and you put stockings on. And I was like, well, viruses are so tiny, I explained. And then I said, it's equivalent to taking a handful of sand, throwing it at a chain link fence and expecting the sand to be stopped by the fence. She said, well, the fence stops some particles. So, well, yeah, we're talking about thousands here. And I just said, okay, well, bless you. Have a good day. And she said the same back to me. She seemed like she was a Christian, but the Lord took her pain, or at least most of it anyway. I just said, well, I believe you're not going to have to deal with any surgeries, no more pain. That arthritis and diabetes is gone from you in the name of Jesus, and let her go. And then I walked home with joy. It's so pleasurable and joyful to have the Lord use you and just to be obedient in his leading. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Use me more, Lord, for your glory, for your purpose, for your kingdom, to bring in the lost and to bring signs to those that they might believe because of your goodness, because you already paid for our sin. You already paid for our sickness and disease and our pain. It was already done. And we just give it by faith, by the command of your name, the authority in your name, that at your name, everything that is named will bow at the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So you can do that too. Just speak to the condition, command it to be made well or what it should be, and don't doubt, and it will happen. Jesus is not a liar. He said, whatever you ask, believe that you receive and you'll have it. That includes praying for the sick for others or raising the dead or casting out demons or whatever it is. It's all by faith. And we have, if we are believers, we have the Holy Spirit. We are given power to be witnesses to him in all the world till he comes back. So I just want to encourage you to step out and do the same and love your neighbor and give praise and glory to Jesus. All right. God bless you all. Okay. Bye.